are at the Cotai Arena at the Venetian Macau Resort Hotel on the Macau Peninsula, a short ferry ride southwest of Hong Kong. We have an exciting doubleheader in the lower weight divisions coming your way. First up, we follow the progression of former two-time Olympic champion Zhou Shiming of China as he puts his 3-0 record on the line against Yok Tong Kokijim of Thailand. And then in our main event, Miguel Angel Vasquez defends his lightweight title against undefeated Denis Shapovalov in our main event. Pleased to be joined by Hall of Fame boxing analyst Larry Merchant. And Larry, this is going to be Shiming's fourth pro fight. They've all been here in Macau. You've been here for every one of them. And it's a spectacle.
I feel like a dog barking at boxing's caravan as it tries to open up a trade route in China the way Marco Polo did about 800 years ago from Venice. And we just happened to be in the Venetian Hotel with gondoliers paddling and singing on the third floor. A couple of numbers that indicate why Westerners think this could be a rare and rich territory to explore and exploit. $50 million. That's the amount that two high rollers rolled the casino during the weekend that Pacquiao fought Rios back in November. And what was the hotel's response? They ordered four more events this year. That's how well boxing has done for them. The other figure, $1.75 million. That's the amount that Shiming will have made by the end of tonight in four preliminary main events. So the caravan moves on. We don't know where it's going and where it'll stop. But meanwhile, it's been a gas.
That's right. We're along for the ride. Also joined by former great lightweight champion Ray Boom Boom Mancini. And Ray, from one lightweight champion to another, Miguel Vasquez is going to make his sixth title defense. And Vasquez is far from your typical Mexican fighter. What does he have to do tonight to start to win over more big-time boxing fans?
Well, friend, Miguel Vasquez, also known as Titere, which in Spanish means puppet, is a 5'10 lightweight. So he likes to use his height, his reach, and his boxing ability to defeat his opponents. The knock on him is, because he isn't the typical Mexican fighter that comes forward and initiates the action, then at times he can be boring. But tonight he has an opponent, Shamakov, who will come initiate the action. And if styles make fights, which they do, then this could be a great one.
All right, should be a great night of boxing action. Fans are jacked up here at Cotai Arena. Let's get to the first matchup of the night.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Venetian Macau, Mr. Bob Arum and Top Rank Incorporated proudly present a special Ring of Gold 8-round contest sponsored by Tecate Con Carácter and sanctioned by the PBCC. 8 rounds of boxing in the flyweight division. The three judges in attendance at ringside, Sylvain Lagumbe, Sylvain LeBlanc, and Edward Ligas. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, referee Danrex Taptasan. And now, for the multi-millions watching on television across China and around the world, and the thousands in attendance, from the Venetian Macau, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red with white, official weight, 110, 1.5 pounds. His professional record, an excellent one. 15 victories, including 11 wins by knockout, only 3 defeats. From Bangkok, Thailand, he is Yok Tong Sitchimi Kokiachim. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing gold with blue, officially weighing in at 111 and 3/4 pounds. He's a 3-time medalist in the Olympics, but a 2-time Olympic gold medal champion. Now as a professional in 3 fights, 3 victories. From Guizhou, China, He's the fighting pride of all China, the fist of gold, Zhou Shili!
Okay, I already gave your instructions earlier. Touch gloves, back your corner.
Well, the question I have in my mind is whether the young fighter from Thailand, who has 11 knockouts, is that reflective of his power?
Box.
Or is he really here so that Shamin can show that he can stop somebody?
Well, here we go. The first round of a scheduled 8-rounder here for Zhou Shamin and Yoktong Kokichip. And Shamin's amateur career, very decorated. Let's get it out of the way quickly. A two-time Olympic gold medalist, three-time world championship gold medalist. He's also won a bronze in the 2004 Olympics, a silver in the 2003 World Championships. He's done it all. He's 32 years of age. He'll be 33 in May. So the question is, how quickly do they feel top rank here? They have to move him along before he competes for a quote-unquote championship.
Give it up. Give it up.
Big-time hero and sports icon here in China. But trying to make that transition from a great amateur fighter to the pro ranks, there's always question marks.
Well, right now, the one thing I see that you can see that he's sitting down in his punches. He's not bouncing around like like a lot of amateurs do when they turn pro early on. There's a good combination there. Good combination.
He's much more flat-footed than we've seen him before. Not trying to throw all of his arrows at once.
No, he trains at Freddie Roach's wild card gym in California, and he trains and spars with a lot of heavier guys. As Freddie said, he's got a pretty good chin, and he's got to see what he's made of.
It's a nice right hand by Kokichi. And Larry, you've seen him. I mean, all his professional fights.
Well, he was very excited, overexcited. In his first fight, fought some big, awkward guys, won every round, but left the questions hanging about whether he could be a top professional. And the question's still out there.
You're seeing the early speed and quickness here of Shamin, but Kokichip, he's been countering as well.
Free your hands. Step back.
Well, he does have 15 victories, so I expect to see something out of him.
The interesting thing about the Kokichip's record, though, when you actually look at it, as Kokichip presses forward here, and I don't know what to make of it, if it's boxing in Thailand, but his first 9 opponents were all against opponents who were making their professional debut. It's a two exchange. Big rounds here at the end of the first round. And the crowd fired up as Shamin spins him in the corner and starts to go to work.
Time!
Good opening round. The crowd approves.
Deep breath.
Keep the hands up, and body shot.
Seconds out. Mouthpiece. Come on, mouthpiece.
Good look here at the Koh Tai Arena. Second round action here between Zhou Shamin and Yoktong Kokichip. And Shamin closed the first round in a nice way. his fourth professional fight. And one of the things he said that he has been working on constantly, and it's going to be an evolution. As there you see a nice combination there upstairs by Shabig, is making sure that all his power translates through. So he's been working really hard with Freddie Roach, trying to use his hips more, his legs more.
Step back, no punch. Ready.
Well, you could definitely see, Fred, that he's training with Freddie. He's got a lot of the pro game, in a sense, style down. I mean, like I said, he's not bouncing, he's flat-footed. But I just saw him do a nice move earlier. He slipped a jab, stuck a right hand uppercut to the body. That's a good professional move. And he's moving his head a lot, and he's not getting hit solid. So far, so good. I like what I see.
Kokichim trying to do some body work as well. Nice uppercut inside by Kokichim. A lot less movement early on, no doubt, from Shimon.
There are, half a dozen or so ranked Thai fighters. They have a rich tradition, not just Muay Thai, which this fighter, Kokichim, started out doing, but in boxing as well. I was in Thailand a few years ago and picked up the English language
for a few days
in Bangkok, and there were a full page devoted to boxing every day.
Wow. A couple of good left hands from the Shiming to the body and then upstairs. Kokichim tries to fire back.
You know, the one thing is, like I say, I know he wants to impress, but he's not too quick with his stuff. He's sitting down, he's being patient. I like what I see so far.
Got a big smile on his face, having a good time in there. And you're right, Ray, as he connects with an overhand right. But in the past, I mean, we've seen the hands down. We've seen him switch back and forth from orthodox to southpaw. And we might see some of that stuff tonight, depending on how the fight goes. But right now, early on here, he got a professional demeanor.
Yeah, an interesting thing is that sometimes a fighter will do better against a better fighter than he will do against an awkward kid who's out there. You can't do what you think you like to do, and he's fighting a kid who knows something about boxing, and he's able to stand there with him.
March 1st, World Championship Boxing returns with the highly anticipated rematch between Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. and Brian Vera. Chavez won a highly contested decision last September. Also that night, two-time Olympic champion Vasyl Lomachenko, in only his second pro fight, challenges Orlando Salido for a featherweight title.
Pressure, okay, keep going. You can win.
Okay. Seconds out, come on, seconds out.
Step back.
Box.
Round three here of a scheduled 8-round flyweight matchup between the China Zone. Zhou Shiming going up against Thailand's Yoshan Kokichim. Kokichim told us, look, he's going to try to fight in size for this matchup, which isn't necessarily, he said, his normal style. Likes to kind of be more of a boxer.
Some good body work there.
But he doesn't think that Shiming has a lot of power. And so he feels like
step
that
back,
is his
box,
best approach
back
tonight.
Free your hands.
Attack. And also that way, if he gets inside, he's going to try to go to work the body and slow him down. So we'll see how that works. Right now, though, Shiming's speed is getting the best of Kokichi.
Yeah, he's taking a lot of solid punches.
You know, Fred, they say a lot of times guys will punch hard, but as long as they hit you a lot. It's like, you know, they wear you down by the volume of punches.
Well, the way he was throwing punches in the previous fights, it was like, you know, trying to chop down a tree with a butter knife. But Now it's more of a steak knife.
Oh, nice quick left hook, and then he comes over with the right as well. And so Shemming starting to settle in here in the third round. Two uppercuts there, and Kokichim comes right back with a couple of his own. Nice left hook from Shemming. Good action here in the third round. Kokichim almost tailor-made right now for Shemming because he's coming in low. He's got his head right there, and his hands aren't all the way up. So Shemming's able to really pop his jab a little bit.
He's a tough little guy, though, the Thai fighter. He keeps coming. He's trying to stay in there, hoping it'll land something to change the fight. And he's come close a few times.
So, you know, like I said, Shemming gives a lot of head movement, feints, slides in and out with his feet. That's what I'm more impressed with, his footwork. Slides in and out.
Crowd's starting to get into it, and here we see some of the
way. The way Shemming is fighting in this fight, you know, speaks to his dedication to craft, that he really understands the necessity of trying to modify his old style. And he's obviously worked at it. He's despite all he's accomplished, despite the money he's made, he's still ambitious. It says a lot about his temperament that he's able to do this.
No, you're perfect. You're absolutely right, Larry. He's nice and controlled right now. He's got his composure.
And he likes being a showman. You definitely see that. The crowd is starting to get fired up. He had a big smile on his face in the middle of the ring. June 7th on HBO pay-per-view, Miguel Cotto moves up to middleweight to face division kingpin Sergio Martinez for his title. As we get started here at round four, Cotai Arena between Zhou Shemming and Yoktong Kokichim. And Larry, just a little bit more on what you were talking about in terms of him. Oh, wanted to really develop as a professional and not resting on his amateur laurels. Freddie Roach told us, as you're starting to see, punches with a little bit more bad intentions here from Shemming in the fourth round. But Freddie Roach told us that, you know what? He hasn't been in a lot of wars, so even though he's 32 years of age, it's the wars that really take years off you. And the other thing that his camp said is that he hasn't done a lot of running. And for fighters who've done a lot of running as they get older, it takes a lot out of their legs. So basically, he's fresh, and they're counting on that in his development as a pro.
I think he's a young 32, whatever that means. In terms of his attitude, he's not an old pro trying to defend what he's got. He's a young pro trying to prove something.
Well, I enjoyed talking to him yesterday. You can see he's got a bubbly personality. He enjoys what he's doing. He's just trying to make life fun for him right now. And I enjoy that. You know, I like those type of guys who come in with that attitude in the ring. This is...
Nice right hand there from Shemming. And what you hear the crowd yelling there is Chow Yo, which I'm being told means work hard.
Now, the first thing that comes to my mind is the crowd, which is not a sophisticated boxing crowd.
Right.
Are they mistaking his old movement, throwing hundreds of punches, for what he's doing now? We're looking at it from the attitude of people who've seen gazillions of fights and wondering whether he can go to the top level, but they're seeing somebody who's not the Rafe that they're used to seeing.
That was a good point. Because I tell you what, I'm impressed with what I see. He controls. He's got his composure. He's measuring his punches. He's sharp. I'm telling you, I'm impressed. Freddie's did a tremendous job with him.
Shemaine settling in now with some nice body shots, ripping rights. And also, you'll notice every once in a while, he will switch to southpaw as well for just a quick moment. And starting to play around a little bit more there, dropping the hands a little bit. Quick 1-2s to the head of Kokiche, and he catches him there with a quick right, and then goes to the right side of the body to end the round.
Only four out. Keep your
Seconds out. Midway through this eight-round bout between Zhou Shiming and Yokong Kokichi. Incidentally, Kokichi, his real name is Watana Ponbon. And the way things work over in Thailand is that you fight, you represent your gym, and so it's a Koki gym there in Thailand that Yokong is fighting under. Nice right hand there by Shiming, and then he comes back downstairs, and Yokong means golden jet.
You know, the reason that he found it hard to believe that Shiming was making as much money as he has is he told us he didn't know how much money he was getting for this fight. It's not going to be counted with a lot of zeros, I can assure you.
Standing in there tough, though, so far in the fifth round.
You know, I see he's trying to, the Thailander's trying, you know, he just can't figure out Shiming out. His speed, you know, his footwork, like I said, he's in and out. He just can't figure him out. He's trying, though. He's trying hard.
Five-punch combination right there for Shiming.
And a boy.
Kokichi says, bring it. And that wakes up the crowd here. Because, Larry, you mentioned it to the crowd there. They're used to all the flash and the excitement. They want to see the hands down. They want to see him bouncing in and out and running around the ring.
But with it all, Shiming, as you've been mentioning, Ray, maintains his poise. He seems to be in control of not just his opponent, but himself.
And that's the biggest thing I look for when a new, young professional. But in Shiming's case, they said he's had an extensive amateur career. It's almost like he had a pro career here in China as an amateur.
Well, you know, he got $1 million, according to Top Rank, from the Chinese government to stay as an amateur.
So here's a little bit of what we're talking about here. He'll switch back and forth, guys. From the southpaw orthodox fighter, there you see he'll come in and out, comes at awkward angles, and he's caught Kokichi a few times here over the last 25 seconds of this fifth round.
Now it seems like he's kind of torturing the Thai fighter.
Tuesday night at 10 p.m. on Real Sports, we look back at the worst plane crash in professional sports, which claimed the lives of an entire Russian hockey team.
สองยกพี่ดีมากเลยเฮ้ยนี่เฮ้ย
ซีโม
บอกไว้บอกไว้บอกไว้นี่ต้องเหนื่อยนั่งอยู่ไม่ได้ล่ะเฮ้ยเฮ้ยเฮ้ย
And there you saw the corner of a Kokichin telling him three more. Let's listen to Freddie Roach real quickly.
Let's go with the 1-2 right down the middle.
You know, this is Chimane's first eight-round fight. Many amateurs have the talent to beat even good pros for two or three rounds. You know, can you endure?
Go back. Please wipe him. Wipe him up.
When it gets tough out there.
Too much.
Cleaning up some of the water that was sprinkled there on Kokichin.
Okay, time in.
Hopkinson said a little too much. And so now we're underway here in the sixth round.
Kokichin.
I worked on it all week, Greg.
Kokichin's corner. They told three more rounds. But they didn't tell me anything else.
That's right.
They didn't tell me anything to do.
That's right.
What's your head?
I think that's their way of saying,
you gotta
win this fight. You gotta go out and do something.
Or just finish on your feet.
Yeah, well, he's trying.
A part of the corner, I've always said, man, part of the corner is that extra pair of eyes. They gotta give you some type of direction.
Well, he said he was gonna try to bring the fight to Chimane. He said he was gonna try to fight inside. He's definitely trying to do that. I'm not sure it's working out in his favor.
I think he just got hurt.
Nice counters here. And Chimane sizing him up and going to work. Through a couple of nice right hands and showing off his speed.
And here we see, Chimane just standing and fighting in the pocket at close quarters.
I'm impressed, like I gotta tell you. Did not expect this. You know what I also like? There's very few clinches. They're pulling their hands down in fighting, which is a lost art.
Step back. No hold.
Well, there's one.
Ready.
You knew it was gonna happen, right? Minute left here in the sixth round. Is it potentially weighing on a young fighter's mind at all here? This is his fourth professional fight. He's yet to sweet victory, by the way, of a knockout. Is it start to weigh in on his mind? Could it be that, you know what, I got a couple rounds left to see if I can send this crowd home happy with a knockout?
Yeah, and send the media home happy as well.
But, you know, the first and foremost, you have to, is to win the fight. The best, easiest way possible.
Well, here we go. 30 seconds left here in the sixth round. The Kokichin firing back. Give him credit. But it's the second time in this round that we've seen Chimane be able to do some serious damage.
No, they're telling the Kokichin by holding, yet you got Chimane with his elbow across his face. Come on.
Nice right hand in the body by Chimane. Kokichin is going to make it out of the sixth round. As the two fighters touch gloves, show a good sportsmanship. But it's all Zhou Chimane here at Cotai Arena. Look now at Chimane, Ray. And here he is standing toe-to-toe, but it doesn't slow down his quickness at all.
No, as I said, he stays in the pocket. He throws short, quick punches. His hands are fast. And you see how he moves around his opponent? His footwork is probably the biggest thing that I'm impressed with. He moves in and out, side to side, around this guy. That's a professional fighter there. Those are professional moves.
What do you think, Blair? So,
well, I think this is
seconds out. Wipe it off.
A part of his evolution that is important.
But he's also showed that he doesn't, even standing and delivering, he doesn't have, you know, serious power.
He's landed two hard rights there, and Kokichin's been able to deal with him. There's a third right hand in this seventh round.
Step back, no holding.
But you can't say that he's not putting on an entertaining fight. He's putting on a show for his fans.
Good 1-2. Throws six punches, seven in a row before Kokichin returns fire. There's a good jab as well. So the speed and the quickness on display here in the seventh round. And he'll hit you from anywhere, whether he's backing up.
And he'll be fighting a better class of opponent, assuming he wins this fight. Going up to 10 rounds.
What they're waiting
seven,
for here at
Cotai
Arena.
Ready. Box.
Minute 30 left here in the seventh round.
No.
A slip.
So that was a knockdown. I don't care.
Paul's in a slip.
I agree with you, Ray.
He hit him with a jab or something.
He wouldn't have
gone
down if he didn't get
That's
hit.
That's right. That's exactly right.
So we'll have to take a look at that in between rounds. With Shamin trying to make sure that this fight doesn't go past.
In this round.
Second knockdown of the round for Zhou Shiming. And now the fight is over. The third knockdown in the seventh round. Tao comes in and Shiming celebrates the first knockout of his professional career.
Oh, this is something that he wanted, his promoters wanted. They wanted to show that he can not only fight professionally, but he can be dominant professionally. And his opponent, who took a lot of shots tonight, is still on his back.
Yeah, let's give Yotam Kokichin credit, because he stood in there, he charged, he came forward, he wanted to make a fight of it, but Shiming was too much in the seventh round. It's the longest that he's ever gone in his short pro career. But he's able to get the knockout there in the seventh, dropping Kokichin to the canvas three times. So good news to report right now. Kokichin is up now in the neutral corner, and he's sitting there on a stool. And so, Ray, that's definitely what we like to see. But this is the guy, Ray, who was able to methodically do his business early on, because he's really working on trying to change that style from being that amateur style and get a little bit more polished as a pro. So he didn't start out with all the antics early on, worked the body, went upstairs, and then in the seventh round it paid dividends, and there's the first knockdown with a right to the head.
See, that was a knockdown. That was a knockdown, Fran. The referee can say what he wants.
So Kokichin gets robbed of a knockdown there in the seventh. But Shiming wanted to make sure it was going to be academic. That was the second knockdown around for him. And then, see you later.
Fran, good straight short punches. I mean, I was impressed, I got to tell you. The progression he's made since the first fight I saw him to now is tremendous.
Pretty early, obviously, in his career, so he now moves to 4-0 here. I know his camp wants to see if they could potentially get him a championship fight towards the end of 2014. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a second, but for now, let's head inside the ring and throw it to Michael Buffer, who's got the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Venetian Macau, this fight comes to an end at 2 minutes, 9 seconds, round number 7. winning his first KO. His record now, 4 fights, 4 victories, 1 knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by knockout victory, the fighting pride of all China, the fist of gold, Zhou Shi!
Well, 1 fight in the books, but before we move ahead to our main event between Miguel Angel Vasquez and Denis Shabakov, let's take a look at what's on the HBO Sports calendar in the coming month.